Have no fear, Count Draco's here, back at Stockenberry Gun Club with my main man, Mike. How you feeling, Mike?
Feeling really good. Feeling really good.
Revolver time, you know, they're my favorites.
I always feel good when I've got, when I got a really special revolver.
Okay.
Right? So many people, I still think, tend to look at revolvers as being kind of old-fashioned, right? Their best day is coming and gone.
Westerns and all that other stuff, hot gun shootouts.
Yeah, and so people tend to think of revolvers as they're slower guns, they're slower to shoot, they're slower to load. That sort of stuff. But I've got a competition revolver in my hands, and this gun is actually designed
for speed,
to go fast. It is designed to go very, very fast, and not just fast as in how it shoots, because we got a tricked out trigger. You're gonna love shooting this gun.
Yeah,
now this gun is not only tricked out in that it is fast and it's got this great sight, it's got all this great setup, but it's also a 9mm. Right, so normally when we think of it, we think of revolvers being 38s or 44s, or something's called a rimmed cartridge, right?
Okay.
Now, 9mm are rimless cartridge, but we've got a way to fix that, and that, take a look at this. This is what's called a moon clip.
A moon clip.
And now you guys think about.
So that's easy access.
Yeah.
It's like I like my women.
Right. And it also holds that rim up higher so the hammer can get to it. But watch something, because we always think of a revolver being slow to load, right?
Of course.
And here, loaded.
Already there, locked and loaded.
Right? Damn. So this is load and unload as quick as any automatic.
Oh, that's crazy.
Right? Now, I gotta show you a really cool tool, because it's always kind of fun. To load these moon clips, right?
Right?
You gotta preload them. So this is what you do at home the day before the fight. Now, if you had to load these regular, you'd have to like take this and kind of fit these in here, and it'd be really tough. But we got ourselves a little tool. So we take our moon clip, take a little tool, we just fit that on here, right? Now we load up the rounds in here, and because we're talking about a revolver, right? We're gonna load up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Uh-oh.
Gotta get another one, huh? 6, right? Overweight. This revolver just keeps getting more special.
Yeah, I see that.
Right? 7. We're gonna load up 7, right?
That's crazy.
There you go. So now we're gonna fit that in there.
Right.
And we go this, and we just give it a little burn.
Legendary.
Boom.
Oh man, and it's already.
We load our moon clip.
Oh shit.
Right? So you see the guys shooting revolvers, they'll go out and they'll have like 30 of these on a little stick right here.
Ready to go.
And they can load their revolvers as fast as anybody else can load their somehow else.
Right? Even faster type.
So I'm gonna have you just take a feel of this, right?
Right.
And we'll see that weapon is
big impact.
Unloaded, right? So go ahead and take a feel of that trigger. Remember, some of the revolvers we've worked with before have been nice, but feel the trigger on this one.
Yeah,
just go ahead and pull that trigger. You feel how light that is, right? So we have a much lighter, faster drop on this trigger. Now, if you pull that hammer back, it locks back in place, that single action.
Oh, man.
Right? It's just a whisper, right?
Yeah.
So what we're going to have
sweet
here.
Nuggets.
Yeah, you bet. So now we've got 9mm, so we've got an easy round to shoot.
Right.
We got a nice, big, heavy platform. We got a long barrel. We got a great trigger. I think we're going to go and have some real success with this.
I think so, too. It looked legendary. Quick, I'm looking forward to that one.
Perfect.
For sure.
So we got the Smith 986 here.
Bang, bang, bang.
And this is a 9mm revolver. We were talking about this is the Pro Series, but this is beyond the Pro Series because we've also had some trigger work done by a guy named John Potagois, who is the best trigger guy in the Midwest.
Shout out to Johnny John.
John Potagois, hands down, bar none. Nobody's even close.
Trigger man.
The guy's an absolute phenom. And this is a competition shooter's gun, and I think you're really going to enjoy this revolver.
Yeah, I love revolvers. I love shooting revolvers.
I'm going to show you. You pop that revolver open, take
load that thing up.
You just drop that right in there.
Easy and smooth.
Right?
Yeah.
So I'm going to have you do that.
All right.
Load that sucker up. In the day when they made revolvers, they didn't have lefties.
Oh, you just get killed.
Yeah, there was no lefties back then.
There we go.
Okay.
So now I'm about to load it. All
right, so now you can go ahead and shoot that trigger pull, but a very smooth trigger pull. Good. Right? So now you kind of feel where that trigger's going to break. There you go, good. Now it's gonna be really. There you go, good.
Get that one. Bullseye time, hold on.
Good.
Yeah.
There you go,
perfect.
Remember, you fired 6.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
A 7 there. I keep forgetting, man. This is a 7. Yeah. So, they got the gun, man. They got 7 in the revolver.
Right. What? So now, what I want you to lean forward.
Lean into it.
Just like you would with an auto.
Gotcha.
So, and then exhale, and a squeeze pull. There you go, much better. Good. Now go ahead and cock that.
Missed the headshot. I ain't getting no bullseyes like I normally do. I ain't been shooting in a couple weeks, man.
You're getting it.
My trigger.
Switching from auto to revolver. And
right.
Back
yeah, yeah.
So I think it's a little bit tricky.
Right.
So
this time when we shoot the weapon, right?
Okay.
Just let that trigger pull.
Right.
Smooth.
Right. Smooth. Yeah.
It's gonna pop right.
Smooth.
Every time, right?
Right.
Just think of it, just be smooth.
Smooth.
You don't have to be fancy,
yeah,
you don't have to be fast,
man.
Right? Just smooth, so
you
just,
smooth,
right?
Man.
You just like slowly pull that back and just let it fall. There you go, now we're right on the edge. Perfect, just be smooth and let your breath exhale. Good, perfect, now we're right there. About revolvers,
that time.
What's different about revolvers
right.
than a lot of other guns is that your follow through is really important.
Right.
You know, so a lot of times you feel like with auto, sometimes you feel like you're just tapping that gun.
Yeah.
Right here, you want that, it's that full trigger pull.
Smooth and easy.
Right, so you want to be smooth and easy, okay?
I like that.
I'm gonna throw up another target.
Okay.
Just have an A zone to shoot at.
All right, cool.
Yeah.
I got the bullseyes on them now. I don't think it ain't.
I think that might have been.
I knew you were going to say that.
One of the things is when we shoot at a target this big, it
right.
oftentimes can make us a little bit sloppy, right?
For sure.
So this time, we'll shoot at this alpha zone.
Okay. Tighten up that data.
Shooting at triangle in the A.
The triangle.
Right?
Yeah.
You want to look at the smallest target you have and kind of focus on that. And I'll tell you with this gun, your breath is important. So when you shoot, exhale, squeeze.
Right.
Okay? And let it just be smooth.
Gotcha. Smooth as can be.
Okay?
Smooth as can be. Let's get that, Mike. I like how that thing reloads and shove them up
yeah.
in there. Boop, boop, boop. You got remember go. Seven in there.
The triangle in the A. Exhale.
Right now I want you to lean forward just a little bit. So we lean back, it's easy to kind of pull that barrel down. There we go. There you go. Now just think about what you're doing because we're hitting low every time.
Right.
That means that as you're pulling the trigger, you're bringing the muzzle down.
Right.
So with your right thumb, go ahead and cock that trigger. There you go, good. And you see if you do it with your right instead of your left, you won't lose contact,
yeah.
right? Exhale, squeeze. There we go. Now you won't pull down so you get an idea of what you're doing. There you go, good. Slow down. Good, perfect. Good. Much better, right?
Yeah.
So with revolvers, as soon as you check the platform, and it doesn't matter if you're going from a single action pistol to a striker fire pistol to a double single action, revolver, always give yourself time to learn that weapon, to learn what it's doing.
Yeah.
And so you can see on your first shots, if you're going low, when you're doing the full trigger pull,
uh-huh.
as opposed to the short trigger pull, you know what you're doing with that full trigger pull, right?
100%.
All the way down.
Pulling all the way down.
And so it's causing that muzzle to doop, doop. Again.
Yeah, the little right. stuff like that goes a long way. So
yep.
when you're shooting, make sure you're paying attention to how low you're shooting, how high you're shooting, how you're shooting at your wrist. Your
yep.
fingers, everything, all the little things, and pay attention to it and try to perfect it, and that'll get better and better every time you shoot, man.
And there's some people who say, you know what, you should just own one gun and only practice with that one gun and do that one gun all
right.
the time. But I got two problems with that. One, you can only have one lady, right? And that, right? But so you need a lot of guns.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, because otherwise, it's like.
You got to run out of options
right?
in life.
You got one or the other, right?
Yeah, yeah. I got a whole lot of guns, a whole lot of ladies. So.
Yeah. right? But I'll tell you, if you've got one gun, and that's the one you want to train at the most, that's good. But always mix it up. Try something different, throw something in, because it's going to teach you a lot about how you're pulling the trigger,
right?
right? So if you're doing this with a trigger pull, it's telling me right away, I know I'm pulling down a little bit.
Right.
So I'm pulling down with my real gun, with my regular gun, my trigger, because I'm used to it, I'm compensating. So I can
compensate,
perfect
yeah.
myself by challenging myself with that.
It makes sense to me.
There we go, man.
So that was another drill with a competition revolver, dope, 7 rounds in there. I never seen that in my life, man. It was such a smooth shooting gun. I liked it. It was a little different. I'm using big old bullets, bah, 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 out of revolvers. But hey, it's good. Good to learn. Good to try different things. Like he said, some of y'all just got one woman. You know, get assortment of guns. Me, I got a buffet, a booty, and a buffet of bullets. I'm out. Three of them.
Have no fear. Count Director was here back in Stock and Barrel Gun Club with my main man, Mike. How you feeling, Mike?
Feeling good. Feeling really good.
Yeah.
You know, all the videos we're doing, I talk a lot about training,
right,
and how important it is. My background, I train professional fighters.
For sure.
Right? And I'll tell you something about when people think they want to fight, right?
Fight.
When they think they're pretty good.
Guys, yeah,
they go out there and they start hitting the heavy bag, right? And they go, boom, look at my jab. My jab is quick. Yeah. My jab is fast. My jab, they're hitting mitts. Boom, boom, boom. They hit those mitts. Boom, boom, boom. Super fast. Now all of a sudden you put somebody in front of them.
A human in front of them.
Right? Who's moving,
yeah,
who's pushing them, who's closing space, right? And who's trying to hit them back.
Right.
Right? And all of a sudden you watch this jab, it goes from right here to being, right?
Okay. Yeah.
Well, why would we think a gunfight's gonna be any different?
It's not.
Right? Why would we think a gunfight, you're at the range and you're shooting your tight little groups when you're shooting slow and you're shooting in the safety of the range, why do we think it's gonna be any different?
That's crazy.
Right?
Yeah.
I think people get into a gunfight and they're doing the same thing,
whatever,
right?
Like
they do with their jab. So it's very difficult, however, to train with speed and stress and particularly moving your body around with a real gun because obviously it's really dangerous.
That's okay.
Right? So we do classes where we try to add the stress. We do a close quarter combat class. You're dealing with a target really close, and you've done the running man drill with us in the past, so we add some stress. But really, that's about as dangerous as we can get with a live gun, right?
Very, very much.
We can't have you drawn from the ground and shooting over your own feet, right? We can't have you like turning 360 degrees,
doing
all that stuff. Too much going around. So, been looking for a way to train safely. Now, law enforcement has had this for a long time with a product called Force on Force, right? Force on Force is a product created by Federal or ATK, and it is a safe round. Now, when I say safe, I don't mean it's completely safe, right? You can put an eye out, right? You can get burned using this, but it's much, much safer, obviously, than a standard. So it can look like this, right? So that's like a paintball round. And then they use like this, which is a non-marker round. But you can see it's about the same size as a standard 9mm round, right? So it fits into a gun that's a standard 9mm handgun, right? So this is a Glock frame with the simmunitions or force on force top, you bet, right? So you can put that in there. Now, if we train with this, and please use this primarily to show when they should shoot, judgment training, that sort of stuff. We're the only range that can do this type of training for civilians.
Oh, that's legendary.
We're the only range that can do this, and it's a new program for us. And what we found is awesome. We can take people onto basically like an obstacle course or shooting course and put them into very unusual positions. So today we're gonna go out and do a drill. We call it flip and shoot.
Right?
Where you're actually gonna, your body is actually gonna get flipped up in the air and you gotta come out and shoot. Something we could never do.
Yeah, I've done it before. Y'all saw it.
Yep. So, in fact, we're kind of taking this from your real life experience where you're also, you're rolling around and coming up with a gun and how can you deploy that gun?
Right.
Well, the reason for this isn't necessarily to teach people to do what you did in California, right?
Right.
To roll up. But it's to show that if you expand your training, then you can be confident that no matter what situation you get in, you're trapped in your car, you've been punched, your nose is broken, you're hurt, you're being pushed, somebody's choking you, you're on your belly, you're on your back, you're on your side, wherever you are, you'll be able to deploy your weapon and use those skills.
For sure.
And it's such a great confidence boost, right?
Most definitely.
To know I can put myself in this awkward or weird position, I can do something unexpected, and still be able to handle my weapon and handle my weapon in a way where I'll be safe to myself and my loved ones and effective, right, against any hostile target, right? So we're gonna do that today, and I'm very proud of the fact that Stock and Barrel is the only range that's allowed to do this type of simulation.
Yeah, make sure you go to StockandBarrelGunClub.com.
Yep. And we got three different levels of it because we got force on target,
right,
where you're utilizing the firearm against targets, against fixed static targets.
Okay.
We do what's called force on instructor, where myself and some of the other Stock and Barrel players are your bad guys, right? And
right,
so you have to interact with us. And what's nice about that is you learn when not to shoot.
Yeah, that's
as
very
well.
Important. Very,
and,
very, very
and
important.
Not shooting.
Sometimes you get reckless with the gun.
Right.
You know, you gotta be able to.
Well, and it's like if you get and you're angry or in that moment, but still know, okay, I don't have to shoot.
Yeah, I gotta do it.
Right?
Another video when I'm not to do that, I have my gun on, I could have shot him.
Yeah.
I just knocked him out with my feet and hands.
Yeah. And obviously, if you don't shoot,
right,
it's gonna be much cheaper,
big
as
cheaper
far as attorneys,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And much safer,
most
right?
Safer, you know.
And the thing is quite frankly, you're gonna sleep better at night.
Most definitely.
Right? Yeah. Knowing that person got back up, right?
Right?
No matter how, and no matter how much you might think somebody deserves to get
right
shot, you don't deserve to be the person that
right
had to do it, right?
Right?
You don't deserve to see that person's in your face,
yeah, you want
in
to
your mind.
Yeah, like the guy when I knocked him
right
out, I picked him up and held him up.
Yeah,
you know what I'm
right
saying?
Because
you knew what you didn't know you was doing.
Right.
God bless you, man.
Yeah.
Because you could have died. But
right.
I mean,
we're going to give them a chance to turn around.
Most
shoot
definitely
them. They don't get much of a chance
oh, yeah,
to turn
no, no,
around,
no,
right?
No,
so we want to make sure that we're shooting at the right time,
yeah,
and stuff.
Yeah, only
this and this type of training under stress goes a long way towards it. So we're going to show folks that drill,
right,
that's obviously part of a much larger class and,
uh-huh,
and a much larger experience.
Yeah,
but,
I look forward to that.
I think they'll really enjoy it.
Yeah, me too.
All right, let's go flip the shoe.
Let's do that.
Yeah. You know what I mean? I want to keep it real fast. Just cover right there, you know?
Yeah.
On the side. Here we go.
There you go.
And the goofy shoes I did have.
Good.
I my hat on. Like a
right
player. All right, here we go again, round two. And remember, man, you never know what you're gonna be in life, man. Y'all saw a dude try to rob me for my chains, the same chain, try to take my chain. No, I ain't giving nothing, man. What you, So we know that foot mic right here, get that foot.
There you go.
Yeah, sideways, so his whole goddamn sternum out. Don't play with me, man. That happened for real. I picked the gun up. I'm like, man, it didn't go off.
Fear, Mr. Organs. Here I come.